Good morning, students. This is the part 4 of our chapter number 11, Force and Pressure. In the last video, we have seen about a force can change the state of motion. To understand it, activity 11.3 was done. Now, one more example is given for you to understand that it changes its motion and also the direction. That is activity 11.4. In that you have to take a ball and a ruler. Just push the ball and it will go in a level surface. Then put a ruler on its path. Then what will happen? Seedha ja raha hai ball, ek table pe aap usko push karo. What will happen? Aap usko beech mein रूलर डालोगे तो क्या होगा, वो उसको टकरा के वापस आएगा, है ना. सीधा जा रहा था, इट विल स्ट्राइक द रूलर एंड इट विल गो इन द अनदर डायरेक्शन. सो दिस इज टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट द फोर्स कैन चेंज इट्स मोशन एंड ऑल्सो द direction, right? The speed can also be changed and its direction can also be changed. This is called the change in its state of motion. And you can say that a force may bring a change in the state of motion of an object. What is state of motion? Either speed or direction, anything. This is called the state of motion. Does it mean that the application of force would always result in a change in the state of motion of the object? Is it necessary that always it will change its state of motion, or it can change any other thing also? It is a common experience that many a time application of force does not result in a change in the state of motion. For example, a heavy box may not move at all even if you apply the maximum force that you can exert. Here your force is not changing its state of motion. So it is not always necessary that a force will always change, but it may change. If there is a change in the state of motion of an object, means you have applied force. Next topic, it is force can change the shape of an object. Force can change the shape of an object. Okay. So table 11.2 is given. To study the effect of force on object, some situations are given. You have to write whether there is a change in the motion or in shape. Description is given and how to apply force, that is also given. Okay, so first one, it is there a lump of dough on a plate, that is the situation. And how you have to apply force? You have to apply force by pressing it down with your hands. You have to apply force by pressing it down with your hands. Diagram is also shown you. Now what will it change? Will it change motion? Yes or no? No, right? It will not change motion. It will change the shape, right? Okay. Spring fixed on a seat of a bicycle And when you sit on it, what will it change? Will it change its motion? No, it will change the shape. Then, a rubber band suspended from a hook, nail fixed on a wall, as shown in the diagram. Will it change its motion? No, it will change its shape. Last one, it is plastic or a metal scale placed between two bricks. And if you put weight on it, what will happen? Uska motion nahi change hoga, lekin uska shape change ho jayega. It will be bent, right? So, in all these situations, by applying force, there is not a change in the state of motion. There is a change in the shape of an object. So you can say that force can change the shape of an object, right? So you can say that force on an object may change its shape. You would have realized that a force may make an object move from rest, may change the speed of an object if it is moving, may change the direction of motion, may also bring about a change in the shape, right? May cause some or all of these effects. So these are all the effects of force on an object. Either it may be one, two, or all the change. So these are the changes here, these points are given, you can see. These are the effects of force on an object. Now the homework is, you have to read page number 134, that is contact forces and non-contact forces. Read it properly and we will go further. Thank you.